morning, ladies and gentlemen, fellow patriots, our wonderful Merrimack Valley Orchestra, thank you very much for being here. They were fabulous the last time, and they promised to be more fabulous this time. We are happy to be here, and it's not raining. We're proud of our field. I'm a member of the Exchange Club of Lawrence and the Andovers. Many years ago, it was founded in 1947. I think that's 75 years, as the Exchange Club of Lawrence. We service all three communities. And a couple of years ago, we changed our name to reflect that. For 4 years, we've had a Field of Honor. And the town of North Andover has been so cooperative and so helpful to us and so supportive. We can't say enough good about them. Whatever we need, they find a way to help us. And they're providing our electricity this morning. And they mow carefully around the flags. They've just been wonderful. We're proud of the Field of Honor. We're proud to have one of the pillars of our service in exchange as Americanism. It reaches everyone, or it should. And we are proud to be part of this country. We try to uphold the pillars of America. Things get eroded and the waves dash against them and so on, but the basics will never change. It's up to us to defend them. Our motto is E Pluribus Unum, out of many, one. Not out of one, many, which some would do, but out of many, one people, sharing not ethnicity, not origins, not country of origin, not race, but ideals. And freedom knits us together. We're happy to see you. We've seen so many people visit our field in the past 3 weeks. And I get the sense very clearly from all of them that they're happy to have a good way, a comforting way, to express their patriotism.
Bob, raise the mic a little.
A little bit more, okay. All right, that's maybe better.
Okay.
I can't tell up here. Jay, I had a good thought running there too. I have a good memory, but it's short and it'll come back to me. But each flag is a symbol, and symbols are part of our life. Many of you, begin our prayers with the phrase, In nomine Patri. And Patri is father, and patriotism is our father's land. And we should never forget that for all the blessings that these flags represent and the nation that offer them and provide them, we owe a debt to someone greater than ourselves for the opportunities to be Americans. So in the spirit of E Pluribus Unum, please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. The Merrimack Valley Band will lead us in the national anthem. And those who may, please follow along.
Oh,
Thank you. As we do with every exchange meeting, we always have an invocation. And we're blessed to have a good friend of mine whose heart is close to God's to lead us this morning, Mr. Dennis McCarthy.
Friends, we are gathered here as we celebrate Flag Day on our field of honor to recognize that God has blessed us to have a nation of brave men and women who have greatly sacrificed for our country. The Exchange Club of Lawrence and the Andovers is part of the National Exchange Club, and we believe that we are one nation under God, as highlighted in our country's Pledge of Allegiance. Can you hear me? Let us assume a posture for prayer. God, we thank you for the freedom you have given to us and for the price that those we honor have paid so that we can live free. We honor those who currently serve and those who have served in the military, police, firefighters, and first responders. We honor our healthcare professionals, educators, and others in our communities who give themselves and sacrifice their personal well-being so that we may have the opportunity to live a safe, healthy, and prosperous life. Many of those we honor are our fathers and mothers, grandparents, sisters and brothers, children and grandchildren, friends, neighbors, and colleagues. God, please be with all those who serve our nation and in our communities every single day. We ask that you provide your protection, that you would be their guiding light who leads the way, and their rear guard who keeps them safe from behind. God, our hearts ache for those who have lost someone serving our country and in our communities. Comfort those moms and dads, children, and spouses as only you can. Help them feel your strong presence, feel your loving arms around them, and hear your comforting voice. Help them process their pain and grief with hope. We pray that even in their pain, they will see your goodness and be reminded of your love, sustaining them through those difficult times. God, we give you thanks and praise that in our nation today, because of those we honor, we are free to worship, free to pray, and free to speak. May we never take for granted the sacrifices that they have made for us, including the ultimate sacrifice of their life. For this, God, we are incredibly grateful, yet we understand how quickly these freedoms can be taken away. God, you said, ask and you shall receive. We call upon you today, asking to make us a great nation. But more than that, make us good, with a heartbeat that wants every person of every creed and color to know your love, your goodness, and your worth. Give us wisdom and turn our fears to faith as we look to you and you alone for the future of our country and truly live one nation under God with liberty and justice for all. Amen. It is an honor that we now read the dedication that for the person that each one of the flags represents. In memory of Ernest Blaine, served in the Navy in World War II, followed by 30 years in the USAF as a contractor. In memory of Richard F. Gorham, a Vietnam vet, in loving memory, also in the Navy. In memory of Nathaniel Goldman, a World War II veteran, 412th Fighter Squadron, 373rd Fighter Group, 9th Air Force, and a Mason. In honor of James Crane, North Andover Fire Department, May 11th, 1983 to July 8th, 2005. In memory of Alan Furno, Al was very proud of his service in the U.S. Navy from 1956 to 1962. He was stationed in Malta, Puerto Rico, and Brunswick, Maine. He was in the Lebanon crisis, and he's a member of the VFW Post 2104 in North Andover. In memory of Anthony the Bear Fusco, one of the great people anyone would want to know. He passed far too soon, a great exchange club leader and inspiration. He stood for the right thing. In memory of William Lowe, thank you for your service, Bill. Love, your sister, Marine. Bill served in the U.S. Marines. In memory of George Lowe, thank you for your sister, for your service, George. Love, your sister, Lorraine. George served in the U.S. Army. In memory of Warren Lowe, thank you for your service, Warren. Love, your sister, Lorraine. Warren served in the U.S. Navy. In memory of Carl Lowe, thank you for your service, Carl. Love, your sister, Lorraine. Carl also served in the U.S. Navy. In memory of Raymond Lowe, thank you for your service, Raymond. Love, your sister, Lorraine. Raymond also served in the U.S. Navy. In memory of Edward Gaffney, to an amazing husband, father, and grandfather, thank you for your service, Dad. Love, your daughter, Judy. Ed served in the U.S. Navy. In memory of Richard J. McNamara, Jr., joined the Army at the age of 17 and served in the Philippines during World War II, where he was awarded the Silver Star and Purple Heart for gallantry in action. Richard served in the U.S. Army. In honor of SP5 Lawrence Pula, Lawrence was killed in action May 1972. Lawrence served us in the U.S. Army. In memory of William Mahan, U.S. Army, World War II, and the Lawrence Fire Department, also honoring Andrew Looney, U.S. Army, Andover Fire Department, and Daniel Napoli, North Andover Fire Department. Thank you for your service, U.S. Army. In memory of Herbert P. Redmond, served in the Marine Corps in the Korean War, retired in 1956, a wonderful husband and father. In memory of George Scott and George W. Turner, who served in the U.S. Navy. In memory of Ray and Trudy, Laguerre and Ralph Paul, God bless the men and women past and present who serve and have served our country. In memory of Harry McElroy, who served in the U.S. Army. In honor of Roland Maley, who served in the U.S. Navy. In memory of Daniel Joseph Dunneman, for my daddy. Miss you so much, Carrie. Excuse me. In memory of Father Patrick F. Healy, U.S. Army Chaplain, Korea, Vietnam, 25 years. He spent over 20 years serving the veterans and their families at the Chelsea Soldiers Home. Father said he'd do it all again. A close friend said, when you're with him, you feel close to God. Served in the U.S. Army. In memory of David Denny Sullivan, who proudly served his country in the Army during World War II. In memory of SFC Stephen J. Lewis, this flag displayed with gratitude and pride to thank you for your vigilance and dedication to duty and for your enduring love of our country. Through deployments to Iraq and Afghanistan and your commitments to the National Guard, Stephen served in the U.S. Army. In memory of Clifton G. Stone III, Bronze Star recipient, proud member of the North Andover VFW Post 2104, a beloved husband, father, and grandfather, served in the U.S. Army. In memory of George Myers, Gunner Hayes, missing you every day, love you, served in the U.S. Army. In memory of Peter V. O'Sullivan, my dad served in the Army during World War II. He never spoke much about his experience, but we know he never left the U.S. during his time in the Army. In memory of Edward J. Carpenito, proudly served in the U.S. Army as sergeant, devoted husband to wife Connie, and father of three sons. Edward served in the U.S. Army. Alastair Frazier, World War II veteran, U.S. Navy, loved and missed by his family. Douglas Ramsden, you leave behind some of the most cherished memories we have. We love and miss you every day. Honored by the fire department. Thomas Kusha, a proud member of the Army who bravely fought in the Philippines during World War II. Eugene Jackson, a proud member of the Tuskegee Airmen, served in the Air Force.
Thank you, Dennis. We understand you hear some of the short stories that are told on these flags, how much stands behind them. We are proud today and pleased and honored to have a speaker who knows what service means. And whether you like good coffee or you don't like good coffee, you have to know that in the heart of Sal DiFranco, there's always something pro-American brewing. And we are proud to welcome him to the stage and talk to us about the call to serve. Sal DiFranco.
Hello? Can everybody hear me all right? Great. So I have to be honest, when I was given this opportunity to come and speak today, I was not very familiar with the Field of Honor. My wife and I had driven past and admired it from afar, but that was really the extent of our knowledge. So as soon as I got this opportunity, me and my wife decided to take a trip down here and experience it for ourselves. When we stepped into that field, we were struck. The beauty, the organization, the pride, it was incredible. The emotion that it evoked was unlike anything I've experienced in some time. The red, the white, the blue, the stars and the stripes. But it's more than that, isn't it? It's more than those shapes. It's more than those colors. It's more than the combination of those two things. It's what those flags represent. Honor, pride, freedom, sacrifice. The sacrifice of our first responders, our police, our firefighters, our doctors, our EMTs, the sacrifice of our veterans, our military service men and women. What does it mean to be a veteran? What does it mean to serve in the military? My experience as a Navy SEAL over in the Middle East is different than the experience of my father-in-law who served in Vietnam. His experience is different than my wife's grandfather who served at the Battle of the Bulge in World War II, where he received a Silver Star and a Purple Heart, an incredible man. Though our experiences were different, our reasons for service were the same. To defend and protect the Constitution of the United States of America, to defend and protect those who cannot defend themselves, and to protect the freedoms that those who have gone before us had fought and died to preserve. Incredible. Nowhere is this sense of service represented better than in a passage within the U.S. Navy SEAL Creed that I'm going to share with you right now. My loyalty to country and team is beyond reproach. I humbly serve as a guardian to my fellow Americans, always ready to defend those who are unable to defend themselves. I do not advertise the nature of my work, nor seek recognition for my actions. I voluntarily accept the inherent hazards of my profession, placing the welfare and security of others before my own. And although that's in the SEAL Creed, I know that's in the heart of every man and woman who has ever served our country. Now it's our turn to answer the call. These flags are going to come down in the next day or two. But when they do, and when this ends, our mission begins. We must protect, defend, and honor the legacy of those who have fought and died to protect the freedoms that we enjoy today. Thank you very much. God bless America. Thank you for allowing me to speak. It was an absolute honor. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Wonderful orchestra. Share patriot dreams with us. Service club, probably every organization, there's an oldest member. And we are fortunate, hey, we're blessed, I think, for the impact that this gentleman has had on our club, on our community, and on several communities. But everything he does, straight and true, and on the level. And he learned that from his father, I know. So I am pleased and proud to welcome our longest serving member, Mr. Al Tarisi, to the stage. Al.
Either one, huh?
Yeah.
Thank you, Bob. He said the longest serving member. He didn't say the oldest member. We have some old members out back there, Larry Amin, Larry Silver, who are much older than I am. Much, much older. So I'm privileged this morning to read you a little poem that we've read here for the last several years that I think embodies what the flag is about. My name is Old Glory. I am the flag of the United States of America. My name is Old Glory. I fly atop of the world's tallest buildings. I stand watch in America's halls of justice. I fly majestically over great institutions of learning. I stand guard with the greatest military power in the world. Look up and see me. I stand for peace, honor, truth, and justice. I stand for freedom. I am confident. I am arrogant. I am proud. When I am flown with my fellow banners, my head is a little bit higher. My colors a little truer. I bow to no one. I am recognized all over the world. I am worshipped. I am saluted. I am respected. I am revered. I am loved. And I'm feared. I have fought every battle of every war for more than 200 years. Gettysburg, Shiloh, Appomattox, San Juan Hill, the trenches of France, the Argonne Forest, Anzio, Rome, the beaches of Normandy, the deserts of Africa, the cane fields of the Philippines, the rice paddles and jungles of Guam, Okinawa, Japan, Korea, Vietnam, and a score of places long forgotten, but all but those who were with me. I was there. I led my soldiers. I followed them. I watched over them. They loved me. I was on a small hill in Iwo Jima. I was dirty, battle-worn, and tired. But my soldiers cheered me, and I was proud. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of countries that I have helped free. It does not hurt, for I am invincible. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of my country. And when it is by those with whom I have served in battle, it hurts. But I shall overcome, for I am strong. I have slipped the bonds of earth and stand watch over the uncharted new frontiers of space from my vantage point on the moon. I have been a silent witness to all of America's finest hours, but my finest hours comes when I'm torn into strips to be used for bandages for my wounded comrades on the field of battle, when I fly at half-mast to honor my soldiers, and when I lie in the trembling arms of grieving mother at the graveside of her fallen son. I am proud. My name is Old Glory. Dear God, long may I wave. Thank you.
Thank you, Al. It gets better every time. We now have another set of dedications, and our reader is one of our great members, Mr. Frank Kahn. And Frank, we're happy to have you here, and we're happy to have you read some dedications. He's one of our greatest members, a man who has done a great service to build our club. and make it ever more effective. Frank Camp.
In memory of Joseph A. Weber of the Army, Joe joined the Army soon after Pearl Harbor with his friends from Hyde Park. He and one other returned, served proudly under General Patton. In memory of Walter Ryan, 1926 to 1981, Staff Sergeant, Aerial Gunner, U.S. Army Air Corps. In memory of Michael J. Leary, we all miss our papa. He served in the Army. In memory of George E. Whitlock, dedicated with love and respect for your service, Barbara, John, George, Pat, and Betty, served in the Air Force. In memory of Michael A. Sokash, 1913 to 1991, served in World War II, loved by his family. We love and miss you, Pop Pop. He served in the Army. In honor of John O'Connell of the U.S. Navy, served in Vietnam. In honor of Robert Dufresne, U.S. Army, served in Guyana and Panama. In honor of Ralph Ford, U.S. Army, Big Red One, Vietnam. In honor of Robert Gauthier, U.S. Navy. In honor of Shannon Lovejoy, thank you for your service. In memory of Donald Earl Farrow, Sergeant First, First Class Korean War, United States Army. In memory of Graham Cardiff, our beloved brother, proud Marine, and Vietnam veteran, deeply missed, with love, Peter and Lana Schofield. In memory of Glenn G. Barbado, our beloved and cherished nephew, you were so brave and always so loving. Go Mets! With love, Peter and Lana Schofield. In memory of Gary J. Raymond, in loving memory of our brother, you are so deeply missed and loved. With love, Peter and Lana Schofield. In memory of Robert and Josephine Schofield, in loving memory of our parents, with love, Peter and Lana Schofield. In memory of Joseph and Carol Raymond, in loving memory of our parents, with love, Peter and Lana Schofield. In memory of Elwin Jewett, in honor of your service in the Army Air Corps during World War II. In memory of Joseph Properzio, in honor of your service in the Army during World War II. In honor of Lieutenant Frederick W. Stinson, Jr. of the Coast Guard, United States Coast Guard, 1942 to 1945, Battle of the Atlantic, Pacific Theater, LCI 581, first due on Kyushu. In honor of the Schultz family, thank you for your service. In honor of Laura Jean Upton, thank you for your service. In honor of Jeffrey Murphy, thank you for your service. In honor of Joseph W. Keefe, thank you for your service. He served in the Army. In honor of Louis J. Breen, Sr., thank you for your service. He served also in the Army. In honor of David A. Kelleher, Captain USMC Reserve of the Marines. In memory of Carl H. Biermunder, United States Army, Vietnam, 22 plus years of service, husband, father, and opa, that is grandfather, forever in our hearts. In memory of Eric Schenk, we miss you, good friend. You are a light that continues to radiate, gone but not forgotten, served in the Army. In memory of Frank Dixie Dugan, those we love don't go away. They walk beside us every day. Unseen, unheard, but always near. Still loved, still missed, and very dear. Served in the Air Force. In memory of John Donald Ord of Operation Crossroads 1946, served in the Navy. In memory of Kevin Ord Sr., United States Navy, Captain Lawrence Fire Department, Arson Investigator Fire Department was where he served. In memory of John E. Anderson, loving grandfather of Sean and Kyle Percival, a hero is someone who understands the responsibility that comes with his freedom, a quote from Bob Dylan, and he served in the Air Force.
Make sense of this wonderful banner that we pledge allegiance to. We're honored to have the members of Post 2104, the VFW of America, with us, who will perform the folds, the proper folds, of the U.S. flag, and explain the meaning of each. Gentlemen.
On behalf of North Andover, veterans of foreign wars, Post 2104, it is my comrades and mine distinct honor to present to you the 13th fold. Folding the American flag into a triangle gives unique honor and respect to the flag. Have you ever wondered what each of the 13 folds represents? On a macro scale, they represent each of the original 13 colonies. But on a micro scale, there is a much deeper meaning to each fold, which we will now present to you this morning. The first fold is a symbol of life. The second fold is for our belief in eternal life. The third fold is made in honor and remembrance of the veteran, departing rank, who gave a portion of his or her life for the defense of our country and to attain peace throughout the world. The fourth fold stands for our weaker nature. As American citizens, trusting in God, it's to him we turn in times of peace, as well as war, for his divine guidance. The fifth fold is a tribute to America. In the words of Stephen Decatur, our country, in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong. The sixth fold is where our hearts lie. It's with our flag that we pledge allegiance to the same and the republic it stands for. The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces. For it is the armed forces that protect our country and flag against enemies, whether they be foreign or domestic. The eighth fold is a tribute to the one who entered into the valley of the shadow of death, that we might see the light of day, and to honor our mother, for whom it flies on Mother's Day. The ninth fold is a tribute to womanhood. For it is through their faith, love, and loyalty, and devotion that the character of the men and women who have made this country great have been molded. The tenth fold is a tribute to Father, for he has given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country since he or she was first born. The 11th fold. In the eyes of the Hebrew citizens, this represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon, and glorifies in their eyes and God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The 12th fold. In the eyes of a Christian citizen, this represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. The 13th and final fold. When the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our national motto, In God We Trust. After the flag is completely folded and tucked in, it has the appearance of a revolutionary cocked hat, ever reminding us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington and the sailors and Marines who served under Captain John Paul Jones and were followed by their comrades and shipmates in the United States Armed Forces, preserving for us the rights, privileges, and freedoms that we enjoy today.
Receiving the flag on behalf of the Exchange Club of Lawrence and the Andovers, Mr. Exchange, known across this country for years and years of service and guidance, Mr. Larry J. Amin.
I'm here today to fill in a gap, a mistake that was made, an oversight, really, at the Field of Honor ceremonies on June 11th, 2022. And that was that about 30 of the dedications were not read. So I want to say, in order to correct that, for Annie, Sam, Madeline, Sammy, Kelly, Niles, Severus, Ronan, Taylor, and Peg, this is for you. In honor of Tom Casale Sr. and Tom Casale Jr., we love you. They served in the fire department. In honor of Patrick J. Percival, loving grandfather of Sean and Kyle Percival, home of the free because of the brave, served in the Merchant Marines. In memory of Arthur T. McDougall, retired Army Lieutenant Colonel, served in the Pacific in World War II, U.S. Army. In memory of Marjorie E. McDougall, retired U.S. Army Lieutenant Colonel, served in Europe in World War II, Army. In memory of William F. Murphy, retired U.S. Army Sergeant, served in Europe in World War II, U.S. Army. In memory of David Bricado, Korean War, 1951 to 55, served with honor, including 2 years on the USS Quincy. Loving husband, father, poppy, and friend, passed away February 3rd, 2019, U.S. Navy. In memory of Osborne F. Day, Staff Sergeant, U.S. Army in World War II, served in Patton's Third Army and at the Battle of the Bulge, U.S. Army. In memory of Garrett Day, a teacher for special needs students. In honor of Steve Brewer, Major, U.S. Air Force, retired, Northern Watch, U.S. Air Force. In honor of Eric Day, Petty Officer First Class, C-130 Aircrew, Iraqi Freedom, Enduring Freedom, and Noble Eagle, U.S. Navy. In memory of Corporal John Paul Jacobs, we live free because of the brave, United States Marines. In honor of Sergeant James A. Barry, Jr., we live free because of the brave, U.S. Marines. In honor of Sergeant James A. Barry, Jr., we live free because of the brave, U.S. Marines. In memory of Norris Graham, in loving memory of a special father, doting grandpa, and friend to many, may he rest in peace with his beloved wife, Wilma, and shine down on all those who loved him, proudly serving his country in the United States Air Force, Security Forces. In memory of Roger L. Clenny, served in Vietnam, you're flying with the Angels, U.S. Army. In memory of Lieutenant Frank J. Mathias, B-24 pilot in World War II, the best, U.S. Army Air Force. In memory of Ginny Mathias, also the best. In memory of Francis J. McDermott, forever in our hearts, U.S. Navy. In memory of John B. Connors, forever in our hearts, U.S. Army. In memory of Wayne N. Taylor, Vietnam, service from 1969 to 73, served on the USS Saratoga, CV-60. Forever in our hearts, Annie, Sam, Madeline, Sammy, Kelly, Niles, Zavras, Ronan, Taylor, and Peg, U.S. Navy. In memory of Corporal Thomas F. Conlon, soldier and firefighter, U.S. Army, Pearl Harbor survivor, Purple Heart and Bronze Star recipient for heroism in South Pacific. Proud Lawrence firefighter, beloved husband, father, grandfather, great, and great-great-grandfather. We love you and miss you, Dad. The Conlon 7, U.S. Army. In memory of Frank B. Foster, Captain U.S. Army, World War II, United States Army. In memory of Donald C. Finney, Sergeant, 17th Airborne Division, Thunder from Heaven, in World War II, U.S. Army. In memory of Rick Schultz, thank you for your service, U.S. Marines. In memory of Ira N. R. Morgan, U.S. Navy, served throughout World War II on both ships and shore. Rest in peace, Dad, U.S. Navy. In memory of Dwight McQuaid, U.S. Air Force and Roman Sidey, Army. Forever in our hearts, Robin and Steve, Air Force. In honor of Specialist 4th, Robert Pallone, from here to infinity, U.S. Army. In memory of William J. O'Brien, Sr., CPO, U.S. Navy in World War II, dedicated to service, U.S. Navy. In honor of Brian Parker, U.S. Marine, July 21st, 1997 to July 21st, 2001, U.S. Marines. In honor of Kevin Williams, I will fly this flag in honor of my brother Kevin Williams, U.S. Army, resident of North Andover on Concord Street, U.S. Army. In memory of Robert and Madeline Williams, in memory of Robert Williams, U.S. Air Force, served in the Korean War, and in memory of the late Madeline Williams, U.S. Air Force. Thank you.
We kind of like the flag in this club. And part of Exchange Nationwide has always been to honor those who also love it. And in their love, who display it daily. And we have awards here to be presented by Mr. Mike Souza of our club to those who have seen fit to fly our flag every day at their home or business. Mike.
Thanks, Bob. A number of years ago, my wife and I had the privilege of hosting an exchange student from Germany. And we picked her up at the airport, first time coming to the United States. We drove her back to North Andover. We got to North Andover, and I asked her, Sophie, what's your first impression of the United States? Her response was, how many flags you fly. And I think sometimes we take it for granted. If only Sophie could see this field. But as Bob mentioned, What we do is a simple program called Proudly We Hail, and it is to acknowledge a residence and a business in each of our three towns that displays the American flag. And today we're here to honor the ones that were selected this year. When you do it, when you drive around, take a look. There's a lot of flags being flown. So it's a real honor to be able to give it to these businesses. Unfortunately, the Lawrence trophies did not come through in time, and they'll be presented at the scholarship meeting that we have in August. But for Andover and North Andover, the first winner is the Ross McGuire family from Andover. We'll make sure that they get the trophies. The business from Andover is Next Generation Children's Center. From North Andover residents, Mike and Christy Lane. Mike and Christy, when they fly two flags. In the business for North Andover is McDonald's. Thank you.
We'll get them. We'll get them all. Now, let's join in with our wonderful orchestra. You've got some lyrics, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,
Chairman of our How Proudly We Hail Committee is a former North Andover Poet Laureate. And he was tasked 3 years ago to write a poem about the Field of Honor. And he took those letters and constructed a gem. Mike Souza.
Field of Honor. Forever in a field they wave, in rows and columns true. Each soldier's memory proudly etched, loyalty dressed in red, white, and blue. Deeds of honor recognized of times not long ago. Field of flags wave proudly, history written in hearts aglow. Offer silent reverence, quiet prayer, noble servants rightly praised. On through time, pass forever grateful, remembered with flags unfurled and raised.
We are proud to continue our dedications. In memory of Walter J. Coleman, United States Navy, Yeoman Second Class, USS Dutchess, World War II, Navy. In honor of Bob Tuna Turner, Army Infantry Vietnam, 1967-68, including the Tet Offensive, three Purple Hearts, Bronze Star for Valor, North Andover and Lawrence Fire Departments, 28 years of service. Thank you for your service in the Army. In honor of Rocco Ferracci, Navy, World War II, thank you, Dad, for serving in the Navy during World War II. We thank all veterans who sacrificed for the freedoms this country, USA, is built upon. Love and honor the Ferracci family. In memory of Neil Notabart, Tin Can Sailor, USS Borey, DD-704, Korean Conflict, U.S. Navy. In memory of Henry Naley, PFC, U.S. Army Air Force, World War II, the Big One. It says Air Force, but really it was the Army had the Air Force in World War II. In memory of Lavin, Poorman, and Haycock, thank you to all those who serve and have served our country. In memory of Grandpa Cy, Grandpa John, and Papa Tiff, hugs and kisses, the Haycocks, U.S. Navy. In honor of Stephen Pirro, thank you for your brave service to the United States Air Force, Desert Storm, Gulf, and Gulf War. Proud of you, Stephen. Love, Paul and Ma. In honor of Jeff Fiermonte, thank you for your brave service to the Manchester, New Hampshire Police Department.
Appreciate what you do to protect our community. Love your proud father, Police Department. In honor of Robert O'Donnell, veteran United States Army Signal Corps, Army. In honor of Ted Snell, thank you for your service. Happy birthday, Rocky, U.S. Army. In honor of Private First Class Donovan J. Howard, U.S. Army, we're proud of you, son. Thank you for your service. Love you, Mom and Dad, Army. In memory of David J. Minicucci, loving husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and friend to everyone, we love and miss you dearly, Exchange Club. In memory of Charge Mogulin, when you've been in the Army, Dad, Grandpa, we love you and miss you every day. Mom, Christina, Carla, Matt, Joe, Kyle, Jesse, Brittany, Sam, Summer, Caroline, and Remy, U.S. Army. In honor of Martin P. Miller, Sr., NN2C, World War II and Korean War, dedicated to his country and family, U.S. Army. In memory of Frederick C. Soucy, Jr., always loved, never forgotten. In memory of Henry C. Bunton, July 1st, 1923 to October 2nd, 2008. My dad, Uncle Fats, proudly served 2 years without leave in the U.S. Army during World War II as a sharpshooter in Company B, 1553rd, Heavy Pontoon Battalion, and received the Bronze Star for Meritorious Service, U.S. Army. In memory of John J. Kelleher, Jr., Jack, A1C 647th AC&W Squadron, proud veteran of the Korean War, serving in Korea and Japan. We thank you. To know you was to love you, cherishing our happy times and your warm, loving smile. Missing you so much, 1929 to 2021, U.S. Air Force. In memory of Leonard W. Kelleher, Lenny, proud U.S. Navy veteran of the Korean War, serving in Korea and Japan. Thank you for your service to our country and years of service to your community. Cherishing your memory and missing your many stories and loving laughter, 1933 to 2021, U.S. Navy. In memory of Mario Romano and Thomas Hodge, we proudly remember our dads for their military service during World War II. In memory of Fred Seguilo, thank you, Dad, for your service, serving in the underground resistance force in Belgium during World War II, and your unselfish service in the National Guard when you came back to America in 1945. We will always be grateful and thankful. Love your family. In memory of Kirby, America First, Coast Guard. In honor of Nancy and Bill, freedom matters. In memory of Dennis F. Connolly, in memory of my father, Purple Heart recipient, U.S. Navy. In honor of First Sergeant Jeffrey Hatch, thank you for your service, U.S. Army. In memory of Gaetano Medillo, U.S. Navy Chief Petty Officer, Seabees, we will always love and remember you, Dad, U.S. Navy.
I have the privilege of reading the last set of dedications. In memory of Jack Carney, Jack will always be remembered as a loving husband and father. I was honored to work with Jack as a pipe fitter in our family business. It is an honor to dedicate this flag in his name. In memory of John Sullivan, U.S. Air Force, Uncle Johnny, you will always be in our hearts. Love, Caroline and Mo, Air Force. In honor of Martin P. Miller, Sr., NN2C, dedicated to his country and to his family, U.S. Army. In memory of Allison Page Hawks, 1993 to 2020. She began her war with cancer at age 6, from victory to victory, graduating from Methuen High, from Wheelock College, and a master's from Merrimack. She lives in the hearts of hundreds, a teacher who taught us not how to die, but how to live. In honor of David A. Ball, Sr., Army Reserve, 1991 to 1997, 51M Firefighter rank of E-4 Specialist, U.S. Army. In memory of Paul E. McClure, in Jeannie E. Robbins. Mom was an aviation storekeeper, Class A. Dad was a chief petty officer, Naval Aviation's Technical Training Command, U.S. Navy. In memory of Raymond R. Bolster, PFC, U.S. Army, Company 1, 22nd Infantry, World War II, Liberation of the Philippines, U.S. Army. In memory of all who served, they served our country honorably and with distinction in all wars, Army, Navy, Air Force, Coast Guard, Marines, and Merchant Marines. We will miss them. Thanks to them and their families, God bless America, a proud American Legion Auxiliary member. In honor of Second Lieutenant Jackson R. Kohlhauer, U.S. Military Academy Class of 2022, your focus, grit, and perseverance through the USMA was inspiring. You embody the essence of West Point, character, honor, and integrity. Pro multis pauque precedunt, John and Lynn, U.S. Army. In memory of Frank Dixie Dugan, those we love don't go away, they walk beside us every day, unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and very dear, U.S. Air Force. In honor of Roxanne Westcott, to the most kindest, loving sister one could ever have. In honor of Tyler Redelick, deployed active duty U.S. Air Force Special Forces, U.S. Air Force. In honor of Donald C. Redelick, veteran United States Marine Corps, Semper Fi, Marines. In memory of Joe. Joe served in the Army Air Corps. His unit, the 15th Bomb Squadron, made the first strike on July 4th, 1942 against the Germans, U.S. Air Force. In memory of our heavenly angels, Richard Fortier, Rita Fortier, George Porky Fortier, and Phyllis Davies. Forever in our hearts, love Jackie and Jim, U.S. Air Force. In memory of John D. LeMaitre, miss you, always enjoyed our time in the service, love Kathleen, George, Ellen, Matthew, Jim, and Connie, U.S. Army. In honor of Vietnam veterans, those who served and sacrificed so far from home. In memory of Paul T. Brocato, Paul enlisted with his five brothers, all from Andover, in World War II. Thomas, John, George, Edward, and Peter, David the youngest, served in the Navy in the Korean War. All are remembered with love. In honor of Ken St. Hilaire, happy Father's Day. Love, Mike, Justin, Connor, Nathan, Dylan, and Liam, U.S. Army. In honor of Todd J. Giampa, first responder, Haverhill Mass Fire Department, and veteran U.S. Navy. In memory of Willard D. Hatch, Leyte Invasion, October 1944, Philippines Invasion, U.S. Army. In honor of the Gaffney heroes, with gratitude to the men and women of the Gaffney family who served and sacrificed bravely and valiantly to protect our freedoms. In memory of Eugene H. and Gabriella Cayley, we honor their service during World War I, 1943 to 1945, and her support of him. From their very proud family, we love you, U.S. Army. In honor of Gary W. Cayley, we honor his naval service 1977 to 2007. We love you, Gary. In honor of Stanley R. and Catherine M. Souza, my parents, we honor his service during the Korean conflict 1952 and 1953, in her support of him. We'll love you always. In honor of Petty Officer First Class Richard P.J. Guillemette, 28 years active duty, 40 years serving Naval Enlisted Reserve Association, current secretary. Thank you for your service, U.S. Navy. In memory of Lieutenant Commander Stephen R. Harris, 1938 to 2020, 21 years Naval Intelligence, POW in North Korea following the Pueblo incident, recipient of the Purple Heart, taught in Compton, California, Watts High School, led junior ROTC program, U.S. Navy. In memory of Robert Martinez, U.S. Army 8th Infantry Division, 43 Field Artillery Battalion, we love and miss you, U.S. Army. In memory of Joy Hancock Mueller, in loving memory of my mother, whose irreplaceable guidance in my life I desperately miss but continue to look for even in the oldest of ways. In honor of Jack McLeod, thank you for your service, U.S. Army. In honor of Roland Bowdoin, thank you for your service, U.S. Navy.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can say the longest serving president of the Exchange Club of Lawrence and the Andovers, Mr. Armin Bonanno, who when he first came in contact with Exchange was feeding us so well at the Sons of Italy. And we need you. And boy, have we needed him the past 2.5 years. Armin, there'll be plenty of other times, I guess, to say thank you, but I want as many people to hear the thank you for the service you've given this club.
Thank you, Bob.
And he has some closing comments. Following which, the orchestra will play Taps in memory of all who have served and who serve now. Armin?
Thank you, Bob. We do have five final additions that I'm going to read out in memory and in honor of. In memory of Efren Diaz Sr., Sergeant, 101st Engineer Battalion, Yankee Division. In memory of Howard C.K. Spears, worked with Hyman Rickover, GE Nuclear Propulsion. In memory of Sergeant T.J. McAvoy, North Andover Police Department, 33 years with North Andover Police, 25 as Sergeant, missed by all. In honor of Fabio Falonori, Sergeant, U.S. Army, served in Iraq and Afghanistan, over 100 parachute jumps in combat. In honor of all those that have served, thank you for your service from the Travers family. Great way to end it. I have a quick poem that Bob actually handed me, and it was written anonymously by an exchangeite, because the National Exchange really supports these fields of honor, and they started as a result of 9/11. So a lot of other exchange clubs do these fields throughout the country. And someone wrote the following, a field of honor. 41 columns of American flags make for long straight rows of sentinels. One watches a breeze awaken them to their purpose, announcing remembrance of stories too rarely told, not yet forgotten. Awakenings march along the narrow canyon, awaited by those a bit farther on, reaching out tentatively, softly, along the hallowed rows, as if to say, I am ready, sir. Call on me next, sir. My memories still live. And finally, the mnemonic air invites them to action, to wave and to announce the presence of waiting stories, imbued in stars and stripes, rarely told, not yet forgotten, joyous, waving love. Thank you. So it is my privilege to, first of all, thank the chairman of this event, Rick Blaine, who unfortunately was not able to be here because of a wedding in Pennsylvania. Bob Westcott for filling in. So thank you, Bob. The committee, which is too numerous to name, but many are here today. The volunteers, both exchangeites and others, and the presenters today. And also a heartfelt thank you to all the groups, clubs, organizations, and the city officials that have made this activity, our fourth, so successful. For the couple of weeks that it's up. So very much appreciate all those efforts. And I just want to close by saying thank you also for participating and being here today. But also, as I said last year, organizations such as the Exchange Club of Lawrence and the Andovers, we exist because we serve the community, but we also gain our membership from the community. So please think about joining service clubs such as the Exchange. Please see any of our members, myself, Bob, some of the presenters. And again, thank you very much for your attendance today. And best of our appreciation to those in memory of and in honor of that the flags fly. Thank you.
Thank you all so much. Now, for those of you who have flags dedicated in the field, you may claim them today and take them home with you. Some want only the tags, and we appreciate that, but we can take the flags down today. May rain tomorrow morning, so we can't put them away damp, so we're doing a little bit more today than normal, but please, you're welcome to the flags you have sponsored. And thank you all. This orchestra is fabulous. And to offer the utmost respect for all who are remembered and honored at this field and who made and make our life and liberty possible through their service, the Merrimack Valley Concert Band offers TAPS. Please rise.